That's good.
Oh yeah, 100%.
But the problem is just trying.
Thank you.
didn't even save you one. Like, what a guy. What a guy.
This shit, we can't sit down here. Okay, all right. But we all know who it's coming from.
Thank you. Light six.
Girls, oh, we're watching. Hey, how do we get the pass back? Get a close board.
Thank you.
There, go! Yes.
I got one.
Is that you?
Thank you.
perfect.
Thank you.
kindergarten at a Christmas concert.
High school is really not so much, but there's still a lot of kids left in there.
Here's what I'm responsible for, knowing where they play and showing up to get loud.
That is what I know. And see, one way it is. Okay,
so I'm just like,
how do you need to be? I'm like, if there's any time for one kid to get
loud, tonight's the night.
Thank you.
The big one?
The logo one.
Yeah.
Thank you. songs.
Just like the Toronto.
Is there going on over at the
is there
OLMP? They're just playing the draft in the first month. And CCA was up. CCA was up.
The first 6 minutes we were coming out, so I thought we were going to turn that off.
Oh, have fun, bud.
Yeah. Do you watch Barnes?
I find a lot of
we got water in the middle of the room.
volleyball one?
No, I'm
not
going to get to the ball.
Thank you.
shot.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
body is trying to tell me something in my mind.
Yeah.
get too hard about them. Bye.
Okay.
Yep.
Hope we see you next week.
Okay, I hope so too.
How are you doing?
Good, you?
Long time no see?
Yep.
2 years ago, women have been predicting that conservatives would go after other reproductive rights next. And people said, ha-ha, there go those hysterical women being hysterical again. Well, guess what?
This morning, a first-of-its-kind decision by the Alabama Supreme Court that could put families' access to fertility treatments in the post-Roe era at risk. The case in question involved a patient who managed to access the freezer storing frozen embryos at an Alabama fertility clinic. The patient picked up multiple embryos, mistakenly dropped and destroyed them. The state's high court says that patient can now be held liable in a wrongful death lawsuit. The court determined frozen embryos qualify as people under its state law, ruling unborn children are children without exception based on developmental stage.
That's right, the bar has been moved again. From now on in Alabama, life begins when a man notices his first cousin is hot. Just to clarify what's happening here, tens of thousands of women have children using IVF every year. And since it's not possible to do that without creating some excess embryos, the state of Alabama has now ruled that starting a family is basically murder. You know, pro-life. And the way this ruling happened is so crazy. This wasn't even intentional. They just dropped a test tube. You know, back in my day, we had something called the 5-second rule, and it was sacred. It's just weird to say that frozen embryos are legally the same as children. Last time I checked, you're not allowed to store kids in the freezer. And yeah, I checked. And now I'm on some kind of CPS watch. Don't get me wrong, embryos are extremely precious to potential parents, but technically they're just jizz and eggs. That's not a child, that's an appetizer at a very avant-garde Brooklyn restaurant.
Desi, turns out I'm a father now. That's right, say hello to little Ronnie Jr. Oh, look, he's got his dad's eyes. Rock-a-bye, baby. I don't know the rest of the lyrics for that.
Okay, I can tell you're running a scam. I just don't know how yet.
No, this is not a scam, okay? This is a legal child in the state of Alabama, which means I get all the benefits of being a dad without having to be a dad. I get to claim all my taxes. I get maternity leave. I can hang out in the McDonald's ball pit without getting hassled. Best of all, he's my excuse to get all shit I don't want to do. Which reminds me, hey, can we wrap this up already? Because I gotta go feed myself.
Wait, how do you feed an embryo?
You just put little fish food in here. Look, here comes the plan. This is a human life, and it's so precious that people might go to prison for messing with it. So that means I'm a dad, free and clear. Oh no, Ronnie Jr. Oh shit, that's the cops, okay? I thought we defunded those guys. Desi, I gotta flee the state, okay? You didn't see shit.
Okay, all right.
Ended in gunfire. Now, there's still a lot we don't know about the situation.
The good news is we do know one of the heroes that helped stop the shooting. Now, it wasn't Missouri's lax gun laws. It wasn't a good guy with a gun. It wasn't anybody bearing arms. It was just a guy with arms.
Take a look at this video. It shows the moment that one of them was tackled by their hands who were in the right place at the right time.
One guy was hollering and saying, you know, stop him. And as I'm tackling him, I see his weapon.
Bravo to this guy. Bravo. Not just for stopping the shooter, but for executing a flawless tackle in front of the Super Bowl champions. And Travis Kelce is right there, and you're like, watch this form. Look, maybe you think we don't need gun control. But don't pretend there's any level of security that will prevent something like this from happening. There were more than 800 police officers there, and all they could do was react after it happened. Let me put this in football terms. America needs a defensive strategy that will stop a guy from getting the ball in the first place. Not just hope someone tackles him before he gets to the end zone. That's not a winning strategy, unless you're playing the Jets. Also, we need to limit the size of the ball. That ball is a weapon of war. The founders didn't anticipate the ball would be this big. I'm in too deep with this metaphor. I hear it now. You get the idea. I'll tell you what's infuriating, though, is that we're not going to get to have an honest conversation about America's gun problem. Instead, we'll be having a conversation about America's parade problem. Should they have more security? Should they be smaller? Should they replace the confetti with Kevlar? Should the parade just be an email? It's not fun, but those are all the ideas we're allowed to have. Also, one thing I noticed about the media coverage around this is everyone saying, today was supposed to be a celebration. The day started out filled with joy. Shouldn't every day be able to end without a mass shooting? Is our bar really that low? Like, even my shittiest day, my wife leaves me, the IRS audits me, I go to see Madam Webb. I mean, a shitty, shitty day. Even that day deserves to end without a shooting. Maybe I'm just a selfish, selfish optimist. You know what? Like the rest of the country, let's quickly move on from gun violence and talk about something else. As you know, Donald Trump is on trial in every jurisdiction in America. One of the most important trials is down in Georgia, where he's accused of trying to overturn the election. And because this case is so important, it's crucial that the prosecution does everything above board and by the books, a.k.a. not this.
After weeks of mounting questions, Fulton County District Attorney Fonnie Willis acknowledging a romantic relationship with a special prosecutor she hired to lead her case against Donald Trump. And his two co-defendants, Fonnie Willis, benefited from the money her office paid him, saying he had taken him on lavish vacations.
D.A. Willis could be disqualified from the case, so could her office, potentially. This could really bring the investigation back to square one.
Are you kidding me? Seriously, Trump might get off because these two were getting off. The case might be derailed because these two were getting railed. I can't believe a legal team's sexual appetite might destroy this case. Now I finally understand why Trump hired Rudy Giuliani as his lawyer. No one's risking their case to see what he's packed. Should give Fonnie Willis the benefit of the doubt. Maybe she didn't know it was a conflict of interest to have sex with an employee.
In 2012, Fonnie Willis was asked why Fulton County voters should elect her as DA instead of her opponent.
They deserve a DA that won't have sex with his employees. Because they deserve a DA that won't put money in their own pocket.
Ooh. Okay, that's tough. Okay, to be fair, she kept her promise. She did not have sex with his employees, just hers. I guess we call that progress. Now, one of the accusations against Fonnie Willis is that after she hired her boyfriend, he kicked back money to her by taking her on lavish vacations. And today they questioned Nathan Wade about those vacations. And the answers didn't exactly roll off his tongue.
I'm asking if you remember paying for a cab 6 months ago.
drink habits, they can't keep track of them. You're either Davy Crockett or a serial killer. So after today, things are not looking good for Special Prosecutor Nathan Wade, but he does have an option. He sexed his way into this mess. He just might have to sex his way out. His loving is so good that a prosecutor is willing to break the rules for it, that he's going to sex everybody into breaking the rules for him. Sex the judge, sex the jury, sex the bailiff. If the clerk wants some sex, sex the clerk. If Manu Raju is outside the...
Thank you.